But don't love them because you see someone else eating and slapping their spouse, treating their spouse like crap, and you're like, oh, my at least my husband is not beating me because of that. Oh, I'm thankful for my husband. I love him. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Hope you guys are doing okay. So today I want to just have a really short talk. So something just occurred to me and I decided to share, though this thing is something I've written on my Instagram before. It's all about appreciating people around you, loving people truly, and appreciating and being thankful of things you have, things you've been through, your current situation and everything. So I'm going to start with if you are ever thankful because of a bad situation happening to someone, because you think you are better than someone, or someone is not doing as good as you are, that is not being really thankful. Like, being thankful is being thankful regardless of the fact of comparison. If you ever say you are thankful just because you look at someone else's situation and you're like, oh, this person have it worse than I am, they are not better than I am, or they are not as good as I am, that is not thanksgiving. That is comparison. Comparison is not thanksgiving. Comparison is just comparing yourself with what you see about people's lives. It's comparing your physical being, or comparing your inner and physical with someone else's outer, because you cannot see people's inner. You cannot see what is inside them. You cannot see what is happening in their life. Even when they tell you, they only tell you a particular face of what is happening in their life. They don't tell you everything going on in their life. So you are just seeing the outer part of the person, or what they tell you or show you. And then you took your own self, like, you know yourself 100%, you know everything going on in your life, you know the good and the bad, the worst and worse and stuff, and you know everything about yourself, and you just took everything about yourself and you are comparing it to someone's outer part. Don't do that. That is not being thankful. That is not being honest to yourself. If you want to be thankful, look at your situation. See, you are your greatest competitor. You are competing with yourself. You are not competing with everyone, because there is none like you. There is no one like you. There is nobody like Kemi. There is nobody like you. Regardless of the fact that we all bear the same name, we are not the same. So you cannot compare yourself with someone and because of that you feel worse or you feel better. You can't do that. How long are you going to do that? How long are you going to do the comparison game? You can just don't do that. So if you want to be thankful today, I urge you to just be thankful, regardless of whether you think your life is good or your life is better, or you feel like things are going on the way they should go. I think you should still be thankful regardless. You are in charge of your happiness. There are times that you have to consciously make yourself happy. You have to like push yourself to be happy. There are bad days and it's okay to be unhappy. It's okay to cry when you feel like. There are times I cry. I'm like, I look like one of the happiest person ever most times when you see me in person. But there are days I have bad days, I just want to cry, because that is what would solve it at that time. There are times that you cannot explain why you're feeling unhappy or you're feeling sad, and you just need to cry that situation out. And after some time you just figure it out, or you just figure it out and just decide to be happy. But like, a lot of the times things cannot be 100% what we wanted, how we want it. I've mentioned in this channel before that there was a situation where I'd cried about something because there's something I really really wanted and I wasn't getting it. I didn't get it for years, I didn't get it for 2 years, for 3 years, I didn't get it. And even till now, I can't tell you I have 100% gotten to where I want to be in life. I am not 100% where I want to get to in life. I have a lot of dreams and aspiration, and I have dreams I am scared of that I don't even believe myself that I'm going to reach there, but I have faith and I keep on pushing forward. So I'm not talking about the good and the bad of comparison. So like, when it comes to being thankful, don't ever be thankful just because you feel like someone else is worse than you are, or is their situation is worse than your own situation. I think it is wrong. Then when it comes to our loved ones, when it comes to our spouses and our friends, don't ever be thankful just because you feel like, oh, I could have gotten a worse spouse, I would have gotten a worse friend. I think that is a wrong way to see life, to see people you claim to love. When it comes to friendship, if you think you are managing a friend, then I think you shouldn't go into that friendship. If you want to go into any friendship, make sure you love them wholeheartedly, whether good or bad, their worst and their worst are whatever. Just love them and make sure you let them know, this is something you do that I don't really like. But at the same time, make sure that those things you don't like are things you can live with. The same thing with spouse, with relationship. Don't ever go into your relationship with the idea of mending someone or like, oh, it's going to change or something. Don't ever do that. If you want to go, we are all not perfect. Just always recognize that we are all imperfect. And embracing your own imperfection would let you or would help you embrace other people's imperfection and would also recognize those imperfections that you cannot live with. So I would go to like, if you know that you cannot live with someone's imperfection, then don't go into that relationship, don't go into that friendship. There are some imperfection that after some time you grow to like it. But if you see that you're in a relationship and you don't like a particular imperfection and it's something that makes you cringe all the time and you think you cannot tolerate it, then don't continue in that relationship, because going into marriage with that imperfection you don't like won't solve the imperfection, and trying to change the person won't solve it, even after saying it's like after a lot of the time. So I would say that if you want to go into relationship with someone that when you recognize their imperfection is something you can live with. So yeah, so I would go back to being thankful. So if you want to be like, when you look at your spouse, look at the good thing about them you really like, then love them for those good things. That is how to be thankful for your spouse. Love them for the good thing they have, but don't love them because you see someone else eating and slapping their spouse, treating their spouse like crap, and you're like, oh, at least my husband is not beating me. At least my husband is not like doing this and that. Ah, because of that, oh, I'm thankful for my husband, I love him. No, don't do that. That is not how to be thankful. How to be thankful for your spouses is, regardless of their imperfection, you see the good in them. You love them for the good thing in them. So that is the same thing with friends. If you want to love your friend, don't love them because, oh, there are some friends down there that they're always gossiping about each other. They're always fighting every time. At least we are friends. We don't fight all the time. But what about those gossip? There are some friends, they don't tell themselves the truth though, but they go ahead, tell the third party about the other person, they gossip about each other. But right in front, and I learned that this thing is very common among females, like with most females, they do like, they love each other, like when they see each other, hi, like, and behind each other's back, they say crap. Not all females though, I won't even generalize, but a lot of females always do this in front of each other. They do like, oh, we are bestie, and behind the person's back, they are comparing their lives and they are like saying bad things about them and stuff. Like, what of that? What of the bad things you say behind your friend's back? What of like the bad things you do to them, like the crappy things you do to them, cheating and sleeping with their boyfriend, with them, they knowing, but just because you see friends like it's like fighting and stuff and you feel like your own relationship is perfect, your own friendship is perfect. No, that is not perfection. So that I just want to say, that is not perfection. So I'm going to end today by saying that if you want to be thankful for what you have, for the things you're happy for. Be optimistic. Just look at the good side of everything, the same thing with situation of life. Look at the good thing of it. And if you cannot do anything about a situation, make sure you just put it aside and work towards other goals that would help you be happy. Don't stick your head to a situation you have no control over. Like, one thing I would tell you is that no matter what, things will always work out the way you want it to. It might not be how you want it to, it might not be the time you want it to, but things will surely work out. Things you want to surely work out, as far as you don't give up and your eye is on the goal, like you are focused. That's what I just want to tell you guys today. Always be thankful for things you have, for the things that are good in your life, and like, just close your eyes to the negative things and don't compare. Don't be in the comparison game. It is not cute. Don't compare like your happiness. Don't compare your happiness with someone else's own. One thing about comparing happiness is that the positive thing about it is that, oh, you look at someone else's and you're like, ah, thank God I have this. This person doesn't have this. But that same habit going to negativity, when you're having a bad day, when your life is not going as good as you want it to, you compare your inner person and your outer person with someone else's outer good, and you'll be like, oh, their life is so perfect. Comparing your own intimate, your inner thing, your private your private situation with your open situation with someone else's just open situation, and you feel like their life is perfect. So that's the negative part of it. Like, it's all comparison. You are comparing your life to someone else's own. So yeah, that's what I'll tell you guys today. Thank you so much for watching my video, and and I'm here with you in my kitchen today. So probably one of these days I'm going to get like coke and stuff, but one of my friend, my Instagram friend, and she's also on YouTube, she advised me to like start doing cooking videos. So I'm like, okay, probably I'm going to give it a try, give it a shot. I'm not the best cook ever, but then I can spice up your life a little bit. Alright, thank you so much for watching, guys, and thanks for visiting my channel today. If you haven't subscribed to this girl, like, don't you want to watch me all the time? Let's connect. Follow me on Instagram and everything, all the good stuff. Yeah, so thank you so much for watching my video, and do have a great day.